Good morning, YouTube family. How are y'all doing today? I hope y'all are having a wonderful morning so far. Today is December 22nd. I think it's Friday. So, so it's December 22nd, which means there's only 3 more days till Christmas. That's so exciting. So today I got on just my red shirt and my red Disney necklace. Just so excited for Christmas. I'm actually just gonna be filming my 36 week pregnancy update. I have not done one of these yet. I've been wanting to do one for my entire pregnancy. Because I wish I would have done them with Aubrey, just so I could look back and like compare the two, but I didn't. I've been lazy. But anyway, so I decided to start at 36 weeks and make this video since I only have 4 more weeks to go. I just thought I would let y'all know how my whole entire pregnancy has been, basically. And just the excitement of Maverick coming. I'm so excited. But if I keep looking down, it's because one, I have Aubrey in her crib, so she's not napping. I'm trying to get her to take a nap, but so she's in her crib, so I'm watching that. And then also I have, I took notes this week of everything I would like to talk about with you guys. So I'm actually currently 37 weeks pregnant, but you know, I'm gonna do the 36 week update and just tell you how my 36th week went. So for those of you who do not know, this is my second child. His name is Maverick. We didn't know we were having a boy. We did not do the waiting game or anything like that. My daughter, her name is Aubrey, and she is 11 and a half months old. She will be a year old on January 4th. And Maverick is due on January 16th. So they're pretty close. I'm gonna be having 2 babies in about a year. So the toll that has taken on my body has been crazy, but it's okay. It's worth it. It really is. My husband and I, we wanted our kids very close together, and we want our third kid close together as well, but I'm learning through this process, this pregnancy, that I need to give my body a break. This one has been very difficult on me, but it's okay. Whew. That's one of the symptoms, I don't know. One of the things about being pregnant is I'm out of breath all the time. And I just got done running up and down these steps 1,000 times, carrying down all my lights and everything. But so if I'm out of breath, I'm very sorry about that. But let's get started. This has been the longest intro ever. So I use the Bump app to track my pregnancy and just to keep, I don't know, I don't really actually use it. I just look at it every once in a while and be like, oh, I wonder how big he is today. And I do that, but I didn't do like with Aubrey where I was checking it every single day and seeing every single sign and reading all the forms and everything. But I do use the Bump app, and today, or at 36 weeks, it says that the baby is the size of a Popeye. Or not a Popeye, a papaya. Goodness, I'm got pregnancy brain. But it's the size of a papaya, and I'll be 100% honest with you guys. I don't know what a papaya is. I do not know how large a papaya is, but I do know how big my belly is, and so I think he's a big boy. it also says he is 18.7 inches and 5.73 pounds. So to me, that's a pretty big baby, because Aubrey was only like, my husband knows this better than I do, but I think she's like 7 pounds, 2 ounces or something like that. She is very, very small to me anyways. And all my friends are having 10 pound babies, so. So I went to the doctor on Tuesday, which was my exact I was exactly 36 weeks then. And they did check me and I'm 2 centimeters dilated, which is completely normal for me to be dilating a little bit early since my pregnancies are so close together. She said that's normal. You'll probably actually have him a little bit sooner, but maybe not. I mean, just because you're dilating doesn't mean you're going into labor or anything like that. And I don't have any other real labor signs. I have Braxton Hicks, but that's about it. Oh, and he dropped today. Today, yeah. Like, I woke up this morning, I was like, wow, okay. So, I know he dropped over the night. But anyways, and I also found out that I have gained 25 pounds as of Tuesday. So it might be a little bit more now. Ugh. And 25 pounds, it doesn't sound like a lot to me, but it is more than what I gained with Aubrey. I only gained 22 pounds with Aubrey and I lost it within a month of having her. So I'm kind of scared of how high I'm gonna get with this pregnancy. I have noticed that with this last month, or not last month, this last couple weeks, my face has been swollen and my hands and feet, I had to switch to my little sports wedding band because my other ring was just not fitting me as well. So I am having a lot more swelling, but I don't have high blood pressure or any signs or anything to be worried about as for what my doctor told me. It's not a sign of like preeclampsia or anything like that. It's just end of pregnancy swelling. I need to drink more water. I have no new stretch marks, luckily. I do have a lot of stretch marks from Aubrey. I got them all in the last probably week of having her. And then after I had her, a lot of them started showing up, which is weird to me, but yeah, so I don't have any new ones as of right now, but I'm pretty sure I'll get some. Stretch marks are very common with me. It all depends on the person, but I will tell you what I use for my stretch marks. Is this moisturizing oil? And as you see, I'm already almost through with all this. And I've used a lot of different things. I've used the bio oil. I still use that too. I use that only like once a day or something, but that I use like 5 times a day. I use bio oil. I've used the butter lotion by that brand, and I've also just used the regular squirt lotion from that brand. I just go through so much of it, but I'll list that in a link below if y'all are interested. Like I said, I still get stretch marks, but I honestly do believe it's genetics in your body because I moisturize like 5-6 times a day, and I'm probably still going to get them, but it just depends on the person. But I do whatever I can to help. Some of the symptoms I've been having this week or last week was lots and lots of hip and back pain. Oh, it's been miserable. I'm sure you've noticed if I'm rocking back and forth or bouncing a little bit, I am on my medicine ball now. When I talked to my doctor, he said, or she said that this would help relieve some of the pain. So I have been rocking and bouncing on my ball, and I actually love it. I think the ball is really fun. But, and as I said earlier, I have been having Braxton Hicks contractions. Some of them are a little bit painful, but none of them are so terribly bad that I feel like I'm going into labor or anything like that. Now, when I mop or sweep for more than a couple minutes, I do feel like I'm going into labor, and I don't know why, because anything else I do, I don't ever have that feeling. But sweeping, I guess it's just that slight bent over or whatever. I get these sharp pains throughout my whole lower and upper belly, and I get the Braxton Hicks contractions mixed with back cramps, and honestly feel like I'm going into labor, but I just stop and sit down for a couple minutes and I'm fine, and I can go back to finishing what I was doing. The heartburn throughout this whole pregnancy has been very bad. It's been very, very hard on me this time. I had heartburn with Aubrey as well, but not this bad. I can't even figure out what it is I eat necessarily that gives me the heartburn. It's just always towards the end of the day. it's just really bad heartburn. But I love spicy foods. That could be it, because pretty much all I eat, it's the only thing I crave, and Chick-fil-A. But, but who knows, it's just an everyday thing. No matter what I do, I have heartburn. So Tums have been one of my best friends this pregnancy. To talk a little bit about my mood, I don't want to. I'm sure my husband has noticed, and I have noticed. I've been like on edge, and I don't know if it's the anxiety from about to have a second infant in the house, which I'm very excited about, but you know, you always get that little pre-jitters or whatever. But I've just been a little moody. Everything sets me off, like the littlest things. I'm normally not the kind of person that gets too angry about things, but if you ask my husband, lately it's been cray cray. I get mad over everything, and I don't mean to, and as soon as I get mad, I'm like, why am I mad? But it's whatever. Hopefully that will pass this week. I feel like I'm in a better mood, but I'm running off coffee right now, which I know you're not supposed to have coffee or caffeine when you're pregnant, but you know, I did with Aubrey and she's fine. I'm gonna get so many hate comments, I just know it. Then what else was I gonna talk about? I think that's it. I don't really have any other problems. This pregnancy has been, it's been a lot harder than with Aubrey's, but it still feels worth it every step of the way. Everything has just been great. I guess I feel huge. I am gonna show y'all my stomach, so I hope that don't throw y'all off too much. Like if you're pregnant and you're like scared what your body's gonna look like after you have a baby, because I do have all those stretch marks from Aubrey. It happens. Like they fade. They really do. They're a lot lighter than they used to be. But I'll go ahead and show you this tummy. I'm so awkward. Okay. And that was the bottle, by the way. I did not just fart. This is my tummy. Sorry for the lighting. I'm using my halo, or not my halo. Yeah, my halo light today because it's very gloomy outside. But this is my 36 week belly. And I am wearing motherhood maternity clothing for the most part. These are motherhood maternity leggings, and I'm pretty sure the shirts motherhood attorney as well. This is my belly. This all the stretch marks I was telling y'all about. But I don't feel self-conscious about them at all. My husband is very great with making sure I always feel good about myself. So he tells me it's like my tiger belt. So I like that. And they go all the way around. Not on my back though. But it's my tiger belt. So I don't mind. I don't know if you can see, but I got my little dark line. And this is what happens if you have a belly button ring before getting pregnant. I actually had two belly button rings, and they look, it's all scarred and weird looking now. But so this is my tummy. See, I don't know if you can tell, but he was up here in my ribs. He's definitely dropped past day, so that's exciting. And my stomach is extremely hard. I don't know, I'm pretty sure that's normal about this far along, but it's very, very, it's like rock hard. But yeah, so that's my tummy. And by the way, these leggings are amazing. If I can find them, I'll link them down below, but they're so comfortable. I've owned like 3 or 4 pairs, and they're just great. But okay, well, thank you guys for watching. I'm hoping to have this video up before Christmas, because I hate it when it takes me a long time to edit a video. But so I'm hoping to have this up before Christmas, and I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. And if you do like it and want to see a 37 to 40 week, or you know, however long I last, however long you want to stay in there. If y'all do want to see those videos, make sure you like the video and comment below. Are you pregnant right now? Are you pregnant? Are you wanting to be pregnant or trying to conceive? My husband and I tried very hard to conceive the second time. And what else? What's another question? I don't know. Just tell me that. Are you pregnant and are you wanting to conceive? And if you have any video ideas or video requests, please also comment on those or comment below. Let me know. I am new at this YouTube game, so coming up with ideas for videos is really difficult, a lot more difficult than I thought. But, so like, subscribe, and comment below. Thank you. Bye.